constantly confronted with the reality that my natural bent is not to be filled up with love. It's to be filled up with myself and how, you know, how's this day working out? And for me specifically, you know, I could tell the confessional, embarrassing, convicting stories of the specifics, whether it's in my marriage, you know, with my wife, having to say, I need love to really take me over in this moment, to really love my wife more than I'm loving myself. Or real specifically for us, we were in these last couple of years in the process of doing some remodeling and rebuilding of our house, decided to make some changes to some things that felt very important. And anytime anybody that's ever done any building knows that when you have builders and subcontractors and people that tell you it's going to be done on this day and it's going to cost this much money, those very, you know, natural, normal kind of everyday things can really, at least in my experience, challenge me to a deep place of, am I going to respond with love, or am I going to demand that, hey, this is what you said? That's a real specific thing for me, you know, in this, as I was even writing this song, waking up saying, okay, today I really need love to take me over. I need to put on love. And the thing about it that is so clear in scripture that I'm still learning here at, you know, at this point in my life, still in kindergarten, on how to really love well the people in my life. But it's so clear and obvious in scripture that we can only love well when we know how completely and perfectly and unconditionally loved we are. It's a daily thing for me to connect with that and go, that's true right now. Wow, okay, out of that, you know, like Paul says, the love of Christ compels me. Now I can live a life of love. So it's all about love taking me over. His love taking me over, filling me up, and then taking over my actions and my words and the things I'm thinking and saying and living out of that. I'm thinking love, take me over, love, fill up.